Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Midland High Gymnasium for tonight's volleyball matchup between the Midland High Chemics and the Dow High Chargers. Hi, this is Dave Marsh, along with Sarah Pavlacek, bringing you all the action tonight in a huge match, besides being for the city championship, and as usual, both teams having a very successful season. This one is for all the marbles, Sarah. Both teams 6-0 in the Saginaw Valley League. The winner is your Saginaw Valley League North champion tonight.
There is nothing better as a high school athlete than to play your rival for the championship towards the end of the season. Just in that environment, being an athlete, there's absolutely nothing better for a high school student.
You just got me even more excited than I was before. That's a great point, and you can see the crowd filtering in here at the gym, especially. Great to see the student sections for both schools are ready to roll as we will be underway here in just a little bit. When we look at the records of the two teams, Midland High 28-19-1 overall, as we mentioned, 6-0 in the Saginaw Valley League. They've only lost one set this whole season in league play. Dow High, meanwhile, 20-15-2. Overall, and as we mentioned, 6-0 in the Saginaw Valley League North as well. You can see as we look down on the court there, it's also a senior day for the Midland Chemics, their last home game of the season. And as we look ahead towards this one, kind of some of the keys to this game for Midland High, Coach Tim Zarrell mentioned that serving and passing wins in volleyball. You need to win the serve-pass battle. And so that's the thing he's really focusing on is serving, passing, and minimizing those mistakes. And for Dow, Sarah?
Yeah, Dow's really focusing on their communication. They're also focused on their execution and keeping their ball control. So as far as the communication goes, in an environment like this, as we previously stated, communication is key. Being able to communicate with each other both on the floor and on the bench, communicating the plays and what they're about to do next, that is obviously the biggest key for the Chargers tonight.
Head coach Amy Ewell of the Chargers sharing that with us this week on what she's looking for to find success for Dow High. Tim Zarrell, longtime head coach at Midland High. Talked to him a little bit earlier this evening, and he's excited about the match, like you mentioned. Besides, obviously, it's rivalry week here in town. Midland, Dow play in a number of contests. But in addition to that, of course, playing for the championship. For Midland High, you can look for Ellie Jensen with 431 kills. Grace Reckaway is second for the Chemics at 209. And we'll share a little bit more of the team leaders for the two teams in a little bit. But we now will send it down to the court for our pregame festivities and our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so bright? Whose broad stripes and bright stars
Before we begin tonight's match, the Kinnick Volleyball team would like to recognize the senior members of the Al High team who are participating in their final Midland Al Volleyball match. Join us in congratulating from Al High, number one, Ariana Hempley. Number two,
here for tonight, Midland and Dow High, and we're very excited about this match tonight, Sarah. It seems like two evenly matched teams. You can tell quite a few seniors, Dow with six seniors on their team, and Midland with five, and a couple underclassmen, Alexandra McMath, the sophomore, and Grace Reckaway, also sophomore. Reckaway missed the first 16 matches of the season with an ankle injury, but she's really come on strong, as we mentioned before, 209 kills on the season. That's second on the Chemics team.
Yeah, like you stated earlier, rivalry week, the energy is going to be filled in this gym tonight.
And we will start things off here. Brittany Steer, the senior. She's the libero for the Chemics, and she will start us off serving. This is a best of five matchup here tonight. That one's going to go long, and Chemics go on top early, 1-0. Good serve by Steer to get things started for the Chemics.
And that goes right back to what we talked about before the match started. The communication for the Chargers is key.
Jensen and Emma Wolf at the net put that one away. 2-0 Chemics. Both the hitters kind of kind of dink it over there instead of pound it down. Both teams with that in the early going. Nicely done. That was Brianna Talt, the senior. Puts it away, puts charges on the board.
Now, again, one of the things that the Chargers are looking to do is push that transition. They are looking to continue with the momentum. So we'll see if they are able to do that here.
And they get first serve for Dow, and they even things up at two. That's Jillian Skinner, 5'7 junior, serving for the Chargers. Big for Dow to keep that alive. That one's good. He kept going to Jensen there and finally was able to convert.
Yeah, a couple of powerful hits. A couple powerful hits in that rally.
Well, she's their big hitter. A little controversy there. Ball was clearly blocked out.
I think that might have been one of the issues was it was so obvious down here that the upper official wasn't able to see it and nobody really made the call because they thought it was obvious.
That sails wide, or long, excuse me, into the Chemic lineup comes number two, Kaylee Arnold. She's a senior. And Ariana Hempley, number one, in for Dow. Jim McCaffrey with the serve. Good save. And keep it alive. It was Aaron Sheridan. And that was Nadia Atten. Showing why she is the big force up front for the Chargers. 102 kills on the season. That's in Saginaw Valley League play during the 6-0 Saginaw Valley League. 102 kills for Atten.
Wow, I didn't notice that stat that it was in Saginaw Valley League play. So six matches.
Yeah.
100 and now 103 kills.
Right.
Wow.
And the Wolf serving for Midland. Nice serve. That's going to be an ace for Wolf. She is
nice placement.
Very, very nicely done. Her 65th ace of the year. She's tied for the lead league with Alex McMath at 65, as we mentioned. Wolf serving again. Another bullet. Atten with the kill. And that's going to be point Chargers. Back and forth we go, 5-all.
Again, nice placement for Atten right off the fingertips of the Chemic blocker before it went out of bounds.
Atten with a service there into the net. 17 Grace Reckaway enters the game for the Chemics. The frontline player. Served by Jensen. Atten again. This one goes long. They keep feeding Atten, but Chemics on top 7-5. Also in the front row, senior Haley Sasicki, number three. Along with Aaron Sheridan for the Chemics right now. And tip, Chemics control it. Reckaway keeps it alive. Grace Reckaway with the kill. She left no doubt on that one. Sophomore showing her power.
Again, good placement right around the blocker at the net. He's able to get it right down the line.
Six, Midland on top. Chargers. Sophia Lobo, senior, serving for Dow. Dow. 17 kills, 22 digs. She's one of the team captains for Dow High. Reckaway again, finds the seam, puts it away.
Another heavy hit by Reckaway.
Kaylee Souls, senior, serving for Midland High. And it's Brianna Tult with the kill for Dow. Tult, 25 kills coming in. That's in the second of Valley League matches. She's very effective at placing her hits. He keeps it alive for Midland. Going to Tult again and again. Tult converts.
Yeah, and Tult's in a transition this year. Last year she was the defensive specialist, the libero, and this year she's an outside hitter. I mean, that can't be an easy transition for a high school athlete.
But having that experience really helps her help her be a nice all-around player.
Yeah.
Good cross-court attempt by McMath.
And there you go,
ball
defensive
still,
specialist, Tult.
Still alive. Yep, Tult keeps it. Reckaway again. They're going to have to come up with an answer for her at the net. She's having a field day right now.
And that's another fun thing you like to see from high school players, the smiles that they have on their face and how excited they're able to get. This environment is huge, and like you said, Reckaway having a great night so far. Just getting so excited and fired up.
Haley Sisitke with the ace for the Chemics, 41st of the year. Sisitke recently on the Midland High homecoming court.
I think you know somebody else on the Midland High homecoming court.
That goes into the net. Point Chemics, 12-9, Midland with the lead. Vicky with a nice dig. And that's going to sail long. Wolf tried to find the corner. A little bit long, 12-10. Playing best 3 out of 5. Rally scoring up to 25. Takes 25 to win by 2 to win a set. Great effort by Chemics defensively. Atmore at the net, puts it away. Try to get there for the block, but Atten showing why she is a force at the net.
Yeah, looking from up here, she doesn't look like that much taller than her teammates, but once you see her in person and you're standing right next to her, wow, is she tall.
Explosive at the net. Tall serve and kept alive by Dow.
Wow.
Going to try to find Reckaway again. Still kept it alive. Oh, what a block.
Quinn McCaffrey.
What a play by the 5'10 sophomore McCaffrey. Looked for sure like Midland was going to get that point. But
one-handed block at the net.
Very impressive. And now Dow takes the lead for the first time, up 13-12 here in the first set.
Again, momentum. Momentum in this match is going to be everything.
Volleyball is definitely a game of momentum. Souls, here's a nice receive, and Reckaway tips it out of bounds. Chargers go up by 2. Coach Zero wants to talk this one over. He's calls the timeout with the Chargers trying to squash that momentum just a little bit. Folks, the coverage of this volleyball game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on Saturday, November 14th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to start your training. Learn about MCTV, how to become a TV producer, and get hands-on training to become a volunteer. Costs just $45, which includes your first-year access membership fee. Call the number on the screen, that's 837-3474. Come down to MCTV studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dowd Memorial Library. Or learn more at cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV. Or you can follow us on Facebook.
Gotta get the social media tag in there.
There you go. Chargers out early after this timeout. They're anxious to get back at it, keep that momentum going. Veteran coach Zarrell knows.
Recognizes that transition, recognizes. All right, timeout.
Gotta slow things down.
Get it back on our side.
Tult back on the service line. Look away, retail attempt dug by Atten. Back to Atten for the hit. She got it. You see that one coming. She got the dig. It went right back to her. And Dow High takes a 3-point lead here in the first set.
And that's difficult to defend. I mean, Atten comes at the net, has a couple of nice finesse shots, placing them in different places, and then comes with that strong hit. It's hard to defend.
This time, Rackaway makes no mistake. He fed her one more time, and she buried it.
That also is hard to defend.
Yes, absolutely. Brittany Steer back on the service line for Midland. Steer, a senior. Atten is going to go long there. And it's 15-14.
Actually, that looked like it might have been tipped at the net.
They did call a tip. Kind of a late call there.
I saw the Chargers asking for it. The official says, yes, you are correct.
So 16-13. Big call. Skinner with the serve. Sasicki turns it. Big kill. That's Alex McMath, a sophomore. She's a setter. That time, put that away. McMath now serving for the Chemics. Sheridan, the junior, finds the opening, puts it away, cuts the lead to one.
I think that's the momentum the Chemics were looking for.
Good block, Jensen. Into the net, it's Carly hit, and we're knotted at 16. Obviously an effective timeout by Coach Zarrell. Zarrell, Chemics evening things up. When in doubt, go back to Atten. Looks like she may have thrown that one a little bit, but nevertheless, the officials let that go. Dow High on top, 17-16.
Sometimes when you play it off like that's what you meant to do, they kind of say, that's all right.
Go Midland's way. It's 17 all.
Chargers said, hey, it worked the first time. Let's ask him again, see if he got tipped.
Emma Wolf serving for Midland. Ball sails on her. 18-17. Back and forth we go. Coach Ewell for Dow High calling out instructions to her team. Big kill by Jensen. Got some good power on that one.
That was a confidence strike. She hit the ball and she knew right then, all right, my turn to serve.
Jensen, 331 attack percentage on the year. And that time she follows it up with an ace. Her 60th on the season, and the Chemics take the lead, 19-18. attack percentage. It's kind of like a baseball batting average. And sails long for Jensen. And tied again. As you figure about 250 attack percentage is pretty good in volleyball. Point of reference, Jensen hitting 331 on the year. Sophia Lobo serving. Wrecked away. That one's going to go long. And Dow High goes up 20-19. We're getting to crunch time here in the opening set of this Midland versus Dow volleyball matchup. Suzuki blocked at the net. Templing with the attack. Try to catch by surprise. That's going to be four hits. Talt's attack attempt went into the net rather than the block. So once they hit it, that was four hits. So a point Chemix, 20 off. Back and forth we go.
All right, here's a question for you. How important is that first set in a rivalry match such as this?
It's Talk always about nice momentum. To get off to a good start. That time, Talt finds the spot. Rickaway tried to dig it out, but unable to do so. Saying there's a wet spot on the floor, going to dry that up. Dow High up, 21-20. Arianna Hempfling serving for the Chargers. She has six aces on the season in league play. She's one of the team captains. Into the net, Dow High up two, 22-20. Zero is going to call a timeout. Tried to talk things over here with his team down by two. You hear the Dow High student section fired up over there. Josh Riemel leading the cheers. And the Chemex student faithful respond with a chant of their own.
So yeah, the first set.
Well, you know,
might be the deciding factor in this momentum switching back and forth. We'll
really
see what happens.
It's really how the teams respond to it.
Yeah.
If the winning team lets up a little bit. They leave themselves open. The team that loses it knows they have to dig down a little deeper.
Very true.
Hempfling to serve again, up two. Souls receiving Sasicki's kill attempt goes long. Dow High up 23-20.
Dow High able to come out of the timeout and still earn a point.
So difficult once you get this close to in rally scoring. It's hard to come back from a three-point deficit once you're over 20. Good dig by Steer. Rackaway, no doubt this time.
Right between the blockers, too.
Beautiful set. And with authority, Grace Rackaway cuts the Charger lead to two.
McCaffrey and Skinner were right up at the net. Rackaway was able to find and split those two blockers.
Inch their way back, 23-22.
All set long. Couple points up, tied it.
Sasitke with the serve. That's going to be somehow
wow.
Kept it alive. Oh, what a heads-up play by McMath. Dow kept that alive. It kind of froze everybody, I think, on both teams.
And I think I actually saw a couple of Chemex cheering because they thought that it was already a point. That was a heads-up play.
It's going to be an ace for Suzuki, and just like that, 24-23. Amy Ewell has to call timeout. Dow High in command at 23-20. Midland reels off four straight just like that at set point Chemex. So Yule talking it over with her team. You can see Cheryl doing the same. This one has lived up to its billing so far. Back and forth. I think the biggest lead by anyway was three. Right. Dow High had a couple 3-point leads.
Look at the Chemex spot right back every time.
So we shall see here on set point. Sasicki with the serve for Midland.
And I was thinking, at least she didn't hit it into the net, out of bounds.
Try to put a little extra oomph on that, and it just took off on her. 24 all. Dow High dodges the bullet. And then serves it right back into the net.
That's one of the things with rally scoring. You get it tied at 24, you have to win by two, but serving into the net is just shooting yourself in the foot.
That hurts. Steer with the serve for Midland. Atten. Rejected by the Chemex. McMath at the net along with Wolf, and the Chemex take the first set 26-24. Wow. Wow, if this continues, it's just going to keep getting more electric in here throughout this evening, Sarah.
It is. Again, as we stated before the match, rivalry night, senior night, championship night.
Doesn't get any better.
There is nothing better in high school athletics.
Well, folks, every year MCTV recognizes the people and organizations that create programming for the community of Midland. Join us at this year's Honors Night celebration on November 19th at 6:30 p.m. Ceremony will be held at Creative 360, which is on 1517 Bayless Street in Midland. Please help us honor those who volunteer and work hard to bring you programs like this one. Light refreshments will be provided. And as a community member, I give a shout out to our crew that comes out to all these events. And they come early to get the cameras set up, get the table set up to bring you great coverage of events like this one. So hats off to Matt Richardson, Billy, Jim Malik, and the rest of the crew for all you do for our community. And so we will lace them back up here for set number two. Midland squeaking out that first one. Come from behind win late. You can hear the middle of the student section having a great time over there in the corner.
Wow, it's been a while since I've seen a student section that fun.
So Dow will start the set on the service line. Jillian Skinner doing the honors for the Chargers. Skinner setter, 105 assists for Dow in league play this year, 8 aces. First year on varsity as a setter. Jensen goes for the kill, but it comes right back at her, thanks to Quinn McCaffrey.
Yeah, McCaffrey and Carly hit right up at the net, sent the ball right back into the kind of territory.
Jensen tries it again, dug out nicely by Skinner. Jensen again, this time finds the spot. Chargers diving everywhere, trying to keep that one alive, but to no avail, and ties it up at one.
That is something nice to see. You have not only Chargers diving on the floor, but just giving everything they have. And as we said earlier, a match like this and everything that's on the line, that's what they need to do to get the job done.
Absolutely. McMath, sophomore setter, serving. Captain to kill Tepsicki with the dig. And she tries to take that one over. Put away by Carly Hitt. 5'8 senior.
4'11.
2-1. Chargers.
It's a couple good plays strung together by Carly Hitt.
Absolutely.
Got a block. Next play down, get a kill for your team.
Katie Underhill serving for Dow. Put right back at you, says Hempling with the block, 3-1 Dow. Try Jensen again. Tipped at the net. That was set back by the Chemics. Sheridan and Wolf doing the honors for Midland.
And that goes back to the communication for the Chargers, as we talked about before the match started. A little miscommunication, point Chemics.
Jensen over, that's going to be out. 4-2 Dow. Had really trouble connecting on that play there. Midland. Hatton serving for Dow. Be a kill for Hitt again. Hitt stepping up here in set number two for Dow. Hit on Dow.
And a little mishandled. Let's see if the Chemics are able to take advantage.
Jensen serving, down by two. Sicky keeping it alive at the net. Rickway tries to put away, but Atten with the dig. Again at the net, that's Sicky and Sheridan. Denying the Chargers, point Chemics. Rackaway puts it away. She's a force at the net, Sarah.
Yeah, that's one of those swings that the blockers even got a piece of it. They barely slowed it down, and it was still able to hit the ground for the point.
Chemics in the net. And the Chargers.
5-10.
So the Chargers are coming off strong in the start of the second set.
Rackaway again. Puts it away. Grace Rackaway. Dad, the Northwood men's basketball coach, Jeff Rackaway. But from what I've seen in the early going, she's probably the best athlete in that family.
I was just thinking she seems a little bit more athletic. I was thinking the same thing. It's got to be true.
It's got to be true. Kaylee Soles with the serve for Midland. Oh, what a dig by Wolf. This time, Rickaway goes long.
You know, I do want to recant that statement. When you say best athlete in the family, there's so many females in that family.
It's true.
I'm not sure comparing it to Coach Reck might be more athletic, but I haven't seen the rest of the family.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
I have to recant that statement.
By the end of it, Coach Reck maybe not even make the top five. McMath with a kill for Midland, and we are knotted up at seven.
nowadays you don't see this as of a family. You have the top five, and you're thinking, well, how many girls do you have?
Jab at the net by the Chemex. Breakaway again. Kill again. He is having a great match. Hatton, full attempt into the net. It's a Sitke. It's a Sitke at the line. Midland takes a 2-point lead, 9-7. Done. Caffrey finds the line across court.
Nice placement from the outside over across court. Far line.
Strong hitter. There's a little more in the middle now than she did last year. Tried to set Rackaway. It was a little behind her.
Well, she looked a little unbalanced on that approach.
9-9. Knotted up, Brianna Tult serving for the Chargers. This time it's Emma Wolf finding the spot. Chemex up one. Wolf with 122 kills on the season coming in. Attack percentage 243. East Deer serving. Nicely done. They had two blockers at the net, but she went cross court for the point, tying it up at 10.
That just looked like McCaffrey's replicated hit a couple points before.
Time it's Atten into the net. She tried to go cross court again. Point Chemex. Up play by Atten.
Again, a very, very big athlete, very tall player. She goes up with her approach right down the center of the net. You think she's going to explode on the ball, and all of a sudden she has this little finesse tip right over, finding the spot.
Right back at you, says Emma Wolf. Alertly, the setter finds an opening. And it's Midland by one. Just like the first set, back and forth we go.
I was just thinking, I feel like we've seen this before tonight.
Dig by Kaylee Arnold. Jensen unable to get by Hempfling and hit at the net. And we're knotted at 12.
And they looked a little surprised to be able to get that ball in the net. Like, hey, we hit it. We got the point.
Benson sails long and wide. It's time the Chargers go on top.
Now the Chemex, Jensen looking to cross court hit. Very strong, heavy hit, but it was out of bounds. Point to the Chargers.
Point Chargers, though, with Atten serving.
Chemex blocker ended up touching the net.
Is that what it was?
Yep.
Arnold dove to try to keep it alive. Might have been headed long, but Nevertheless, Dow takes that three-point lead. That seems to be the magic number for Coach Zero. Chargers get that three-point lead. Gets the timeout to try to talk things over, try to stem the tide.
Worked for him in the first set.
It sure did, right around this time, too.
I do have to say, as with the chanting of these two student section, it's very appropriate. It's very...
Yeah, sportsman.
Internal, yes. Yeah. It's Midland Chemex. They're right. Cheering for Midland Chemex. Dow High is cheering for Dow High. That's nice to see in rivalry matches.
Absolutely, absolutely. Frequently in these timeouts, see Dow, Coach Ewell makes a point quickly and the Chargers get out ready to roll. There's up three. Talking things over a little bit more. Atten goes back to the line. She is a powerful force for Dow High at the net and on the back line, especially from the service line. Another may have crossed the center line. Point Chargers.
Yeah, the Chargers have been very aggressive. Being able to get at the net, get a couple of blocks. Even if they don't get blocks, they're still getting touches right at the net. There's another one.
That one's long as well. Dow has figured something out here. On a bit of a roll, now up 5, 17-12. Just wide. Just try to find that line. Just sailed wide. And then cuts it to 4. Jensen serving. Killed out high. Sophia Lobo checks back into the Dow lineup, placing hit. Lobo will serve. Up 5. Sasiki on a quick set in the middle, but it goes a couple feet long. And Dow up 19-13. Coach Zero seen enough. He knows if this lead gets much bigger, it's going to just get away from his team. Dow High trying to knot things up at a set of piece here.
Yeah, as you said, Chemex called 2 quick timeouts. Chargers out of their timeouts just as quickly.
Yep.
They're already back on the court, ready to go.
You know, Nadia Atten is anxious to get out there. She's been on that line. She had been on it for a while, and now it's going to be Lobo serving. Last year, Lobo was usually the back row player. Proved a lot to earn some time in the front row as well. She's got some great hops, passion for the game.
I like to hear you say that. Great hops.
Means she can jump high.
Street lingo.
For the novices up there. Somehow, the Chemex keep it alive. Block goes out of bounds. Dow up 20-13. So both timeouts not working out for Midland. This serve sails long. Dow up 20-14.
I think there might be something about that side of the net. Both teams, when Chargers were over there, they had a couple of mysterious plays, just kind of whimsical plays, and now we see one from the Chemex as well. I'm thinking it might just be that side of the net. What do you think?
Maybe there's a draft or something. Who knows? Kaylee Soule is serving for Midland. Oh, nice dig by Steer. Wreck away, puts it away.
So a really good job by the Chemics to keep that ball in play, stay focused.
Yeah, I give Steer a lot of credit for that one. It looked like it was going to be Dow. She just kept it alive. Chemics able to convert.
Very impressive.
2015. Souls, 5'3 senior, defensive specialist, serving it up for the Chemics.
Blocked by the setter, Jillian Skinner.
Breakaway! Once again, the Amazing Grace. Grace Breakaway with another kill.
I wonder if that one's going to stick. I like it.
I like it, too.
I like it.
And it's appropriate. 2016. Going into the net. 2017. Midland reels off four straight to cut the gap to three, and Emuel has seen enough. Trying to stem the tide here. I hate to give this one away. They're up 7 points. And Midland scratching and clawing their way back to get to within a manageable three.
Yeah, like you said earlier in the first set, once you get to 20, those teeter-tottering back and forth into points is a little bit more difficult to do with only five more to go after hitting the 20-point mark. So we'll see if the Chargers are able to put it away or see if the Chemics can make a comeback.
We shall see. Souls remains on the service line. Going to be an ace for Kaylee Souls. 2018. Souls, 24 aces coming into this match. This time, it's Brianna Talt. Putting it away, 21-18.
Yeah, Talt just unleashed on that one.
Sure did. Hempfling, 5'11 senior. Into the net, 21-19. Kaylee Sasicki gonna try to cut into that 2-point deficit.
Yeah, that's one of the things, again, you can't do with a lead after 20 is service errors. Unless you have a teammate like Tulk.
Yep. Say, here, take care of business, will you? Brianna, she sure did. 22-19, and she will go back to the service line.
Nice dig by Tulk in the back row.
Oh, Steer with a great dig. Breakaway. It is just long. Point Chemics, though. The Charger was in the net. Official call, Chargers in the net. Wow, that's a big call.
It's one of those things, half the people in the gym like that call, half the people in the gym do not like that call.
22-20, Steer with the serve. Atten, dug nicely. Dug nicely by Dow, but it goes wide. Great effort by both teams. The Chemics cut the lead to one. 22-21, Steer serving. And that's an ace for Brittany Steer. Sarah, we are tied at 22.
And guess what? Chargers call a timeout. Final timeout of the set.
Coach Jewell with the timeout. Midland storming back from a 7-point deficit. It was 20-13. They are battling. I like Steer has made some huge defensive plays from a libero position. For Midland High.
And you just go back to this environment. Tie game, 22-22, second set. Very important set.
Yeah, huge. Especially for Dow. Steer, 373 digs on the year with the serve. Into the net. Midland takes the lead. By Steer. It is put away by the Chemics. Emma Wolf with the kill. Set point. Midland high. Unbelievable.
The Chemics are definitely taking advantage of the Charger errors.
Brittany Steer with the ace. And the Chemics come all the way back to win set two, 25-22. Holy cow. Well, we're going to take a little break here for this important message, folks. Spins, drives, touchdown, Chemics.
Good hard hit.
Want to get in the game? Join MCTV as an Access TV producer and produce programs like baseball, basketball, football, and more. Call MCTV at 837-3474 to get started. Get in the game and let's produce a program.
We are back after that great advertisement for MCTV. You can see all the great dramatic sporting events that MCTV produces, and including this one here tonight. Drama here in the Midland High Gymnasium on this winner-take-all matchup. I mentioned before, both teams 6-0 in Saginaw Valley League North play coming in. The winner is the SVL North champion. Both teams having successful seasons on the year. Also, this is for the city title. Midland on top, 2-0.
You also mentioned before the start of the match, the Chemics and their streak this season. They're not only 6-0, but they've only lost 2 sets within those 6 wins. All but their match to Heritage were 3-0 wins. So they've dropped 2 sets to Heritage, 0 to the Chargers so far. We'll see if they're able to keep that streak going.
We'll see. It's a long way from over here. But Brittany Steer, who had a phenomenal end of set two, back on the service line. And it continues to go her way. You mentioned Steer, the libero, 55 aces on the year coming in. 946 serve percentage. Just as I said that one sails wide and we're tied up at 1. Mentioned Steer. By far the leader in digs for the Chemics at 373. It's 3.3 digs per game. Heads up play by Atten to put that away. And it's 2-1 Dow. That one's gonna go long. Dow takes a 3-1 lead. It's also long, 4-1 Dow, just like that. Skinner serving for Dow. That one's down and good. Emma Wolf makes it a 4-2 Dow lead.
Yeah.
McMath with the serve. Point Chemex. Alex McMath has done some damage tonight from the service line. Now with a 1 point lead, 4-3. We are in set number three here in Midland High Gymnasium. Steer with the dig. Gatton with the dig right back. Good work at the net by the Chargers. That's Atten and McCaffrey forming a wall at the net for Dow.
Again, back and forth. Chargers get a couple points up. Chemex respond.
Underhill with the serve. Just off the net. Midland keeps it alive. It's Atten time. Not this time. Jensen with the kill. Dow keeps it alive. It's going to be a double hit. And Midland point. 5-4.
Yeah, the Chargers libero, Katie Underhill, was unable to only connect the ball with one time. It went off her shoulder and her arms. Called for a double hit.
Served by Wolf. Atten with a kill. Nicely done.
Great placement in the back corner.
Atten's tough at that front line. She's had some huge matches this year. That's a big ace for Atten. With 21 in league play coming in. She had some huge matches. 47% attack percentage against Bay City Western and 37 against Mount Pleasant. Wow.
And that's another thing. She was on varsity last year, but she was behind two seniors, so she didn't get to see much action, so she's definitely taking advantage of that this year.
Chargers. A lot of credit to Skinner on that one. Diving dig kept the ball alive. Dow prevails. They go up 8-4. Yeah, they leave it there again. Patton again with the dig. This time, finally put away by Tault. Longest rally of the match. And Dow gets the point, goes up 9-4.
Yeah, Tault had a good connection on the ball previously in the rally, but the Chemex were able to dig it, get it back. She said, not this time.
Tim Zero calls the timeout down by five. We've been in this position before, but hey, give Dow credit right here after losing two heartbreaking sets. They came out flying here in set three. They are not ready to concede this whatsoever.
And I think that also goes back to the leadership on the team. Like you said, there's a lot of seniors. It's senior day. I can't stop going back to the stage that they're on right now with the championship on the line, the city championship on the line. Senior day, last game. Wow, there's just so much happening that there's nothing else for them to lose at this point.
They're not going to give in here whatsoever. Tell you what, Atten has been impressive. You know, we knew that she could do damage at the net, but she is flying all around that backcourt as well.
And she does it with such ease. She does it with a smile on her face, laughing the whole time.
Dribbles it over the net for the point and the ace.
Even when she gets an ace like that.
You could master that serve right there. You'd be on the line a long time. Chargers 11-4. Dow jumps out of the gates. early here. This is the thing, if Dow maintains this, you get that two-set lead. It starts to evaporate on you. This pressure is on the team with the lead at some point.
Yeah. Yeah, it does look like the Chargers are starting to really find their momentum. They're really starting to find each other.
Jensen, junior with the serve. Away, blocks it out of bounds. Point Chargers. Sitke on the line. Comics needed that one. Senior comes through. And Gilly Soles to serve, number seven. Recall when Midland was down in the last set, Soles came in to serve and put a few points together. Comics looking for her to do the same, and she starts with the ace. 12-7. Came in when it was 2013, reeled off about 4 or 5 points in a row, and that really set the stage for the comeback. Yeah. Just found her spot.
I was going to say, again, nice placement cross court.
Didn't need the power when you find the spot right there. Very good at reading what's going on the other side of the net. Chargers, team seven, now on top of Hempling serving. He's also one of the more vocal players for the Chargers. Oh, Souls. Keeps it alive. Midland's going to get the point.
Again, a miscommunication for Chargers.
Diving serve receive was over the net, and kind of befuddled now, looked like, a little bit. Sipke serves. She's going to get the ace. 13-9. By six. Talk to serve. Nicely done. That is Wolf with the kill. Team 10. Now on top with Brittany Steer serving.
Jillian Skinner trying to sneak one through.
Not letting the ball go over the net. Jensen's kill goes long. Her kill attempt. Dow up 16-10. Skinner with a serve, set to Jensen, got it.
She had one right before, missed it a little bit long outside, right down the service line, said, hey, let me try this one again. Gets the second one.
Got it. McMath to serve. Just off the net. And that's going to be a kill for McCaffrey off the block. 17-11 Chargers. Chargers down, two sets to none. It's obviously a must-win situation for them. And they're playing like it. Underhill with the serve. Jensen goes long with the attempt, and it's 18-11. Underhill will serve again. Team's punching at it. This time it's going to roll off the net out of bounds, 19-11. Coach Zarrell has got to use one of those timeouts. Down by eight. We're getting deep into this set. He's got to find a way to turn things around here.
So the Chemex win the first set, 26-24. Go into the second set. Behind towards the end. Come back, win 25-22. Now the Chargers take a 19-11 lead into the third set.
Well, this is kind of the time where Midland rallied the last set. So it's the mindset of Dow is... I hope this doesn't happen again, or is it this is not going to happen again?
And that's where you go to your senior leadership. It's a different story if you have your sophomores or underclassmen on the court. It's a lot easier for the feeling to say, oh, no, please don't let it happen again. But when you have a load of seniors on the court and have that experience, not necessarily with seniors, but experience on the court, that's when it's they say, okay, we found our niche. We know where we're at. We know what we need to do.
So here we go. Underhill still on the service line. Good serve. Free ball for Dow. Atten puts it away. When you need it most, go to the big dog over there. Nadia Atten with a kill. 20-11 Dow. Up by nine. Another nice serve by Underhill. Kind of mixing it up. It's going to go a little wide for Hempfling.
Yeah, I think she was trying to be a little tricky on that one, trying to get around the blockers and just place it. But like you said, pushed it a little bit too hard out of bounds.
Jensen finds the spot, and it's 20-13. Emma Wolf on the service line for the Chemex. Just long. Ball just kind of sailed on her. 21-13. And here comes Atten.
Seems like the ball tends to be in her hand a lot.
Big serve. This time it's put away by Hitt. Dow in control on this one, 22-13. Impressed with the Chargers' effort here in set number three. Dug deep here. Try to keep this match alive. A little wide.
Close call.
Very close.
Very close.
Just missed it. The line judge confident in that call, though.
He's right on top of that one.
Jensen with the serve. That's an ace. 22-15.
Another one of those just trickling over the net. This one didn't get a lot of net, but it got some. Just right over the net on the service ace.
Just kind of throw off the timing of the defenders. Point Chemex. 22-16.
Again, that's the second time that Hemflin's tried to place it. Just an easy little push and was unable to do so successfully.
Again, the Sasicki with the block and then the kill. 22-17. Cut the lead to five. Midland trying to take advantage when Atten's on the back row. So in that defensive position where she can't do damage at the net. You can watch, folks, this Midland versus Dow volleyball match on MPS TV 190 and Charter or Channel 99 on AT&T UVerse in Midland. The event will be shown on upcoming dates and times, Thursday, October 22nd at 8:30 p.m., Friday the 23rd at 8:30, or Saturday the 24th at 11. For more dates and times, or to watch this program online, check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org.
I'm going to have to tell my parents.
You should. They'd be proud of you. Jensen serving. Midland in the net. Unfortunate there. I had that big run to cut it to five. A little confusion at the net. Caught some of the twine, and Dow's up 23-17. Lobo serving. Hatton from the back row. Put away by Hempfling. Set point, Chargers.
Team captain, that's the way to lead your team.
Lobo serving for the set. Hatton ever present there in the back row. That's going to go wide. Galt tried to end it. But instead, it's wide. Midland stays alive in the set. Souls checks back in to serve. McMath also back in for the Chemics. Still set point for Dow.
And this is the same server that dug the Chemics out of last set.
Pretty big hole right here, though. Hempfling got it. And Dow takes the third set, 25-18. We got a ball game, folks. Dow staves off elimination. Again, this is Dave Marsh bringing you all the action tonight, along with Sarah Pavlochik. Exciting action here in Midland High Gymnasium. We knew this was going to be a dogfight. And it has been from the beginning. Midland High with a couple of late set rallies to win the first and second. Dow took control of the third early and put the pedal to the metal and pulled that one off as we head to set number four.
Yeah, late in the third set, the Chargers were leading 18-11. Then the Chemics came back to score six of the next 9 points to pull it closer towards the end, but eventually succumb to the Chargers, winning 25-18.
So now we'll see how Midland responds. This is one of those where Dow has got momentum. They're fired up. If they're able to win this set, you go into the fifth. And kind of the pressure would be on Midland in that situation, having given up a 2-0 lead. So
seen it plenty of times. You start off, again, game of momentum. You started off with the first set. Got into the second set, rallied back to win the second set. Maybe used a lot of energy in those rallies going back and forth. Seen it a lot of times where fifth set comes down to who wants it more, who has the most energy.
Right.
Both teams are going to want this.
Oh, yeah. There's no doubt about that.
But who's able to execute? One of the Chargers' pregame keys, execution. Who's able to execute down the stretch. But this is the fourth set. Chargers are still fighting for their life.
Yeah, they will be serving it up to start things. Midland High student section still fired up. See that they're on camera. Dow High students taking a little break over there.
Yeah, they've been sitting down between the sets, kind of maybe to
conserve a little energy.
Energize.
Smart. See how much energy they have now that we get things started here.
And now they stand up.
It's Nadia Atten. Go to your horse to get things started off strong.
I think everyone in the gym knew that that one was going to Nadia. Yeah.
Julian Skinner, 5'7", junior, serves for Dow. And she serves up an ace. Couldn't start any better for the Chargers. Had the momentum throughout set number three, and they're continuing it here in set four. That was that Lobo putting that away?
Yeah, Sophia Lobo.
3-0, Dow on top early. The force at the net, that's Atten and McCaffrey with the block. And it is 4-0. Hemmicks desperately trying to get on the board here. That one's good too. 5-0. Coach Sarrell does not want to use a timeout this early. Said he's imploring his team to snap out of it here. Jensen made no mistake that time. Block didn't quite get over in time. Chemics are on the board. It's 5-1. McMath to serve for Midland. The net. Midland's. A couple of blocks, but alert play by McCaffrey finds a little opening there and just dinks it over for the point.
Yeah, the Chemics right at the net ready, getting the block, but the Chargers able to have a quick response, get it over the net, find an open location, and that's where they put the ball.
Service error will send it back to the Chemics, 6-2. Atten with a kill.
That ball really, it looked like she hit it hard, but then it looked like it kind of died right before it hit the ground and just fell right in the back service line.
She didn't quite get all that one, but she found the spot. 7-2 Chargers. Atten to serve. She's done a lot of damage from the service line tonight. Midland's out of rotation. Kind of fell asleep there on that point. Looks like that 8-2 Chargers. Point Chemics. That was in the net. 8-3. Jensen serving. put away by the Chemics. 8-4.
Do have to say it is impressive for the Chargers to continue their momentum throughout that third set and into the fourth. We'll see if they have enough for the rest of the match or see if the Chemics can overcome.
Find that opening again. Dow's really done a great job with finding the opening in the Chemic defense. 9-4, Chargers up. Lobo with the serve. Rackaway puts it away. She's been waiting a while for that rotation to come around to get into the match, and as soon as she does, Grace Rackaway makes her presence felt.
Yeah, there's a couple people I've been waiting for. Rackaway to come around in the front row, and also Brianna Tolt for the Chargers. Haven't heard anything from her in a while, so we'll see if she can get going.
Served by Souls, and Atten tries to attack from the back. Unsuccessfully, 9-6, Dow leads. Kaylee Souls serving. Block for the Chemics, that's Sasicki. And McMath at the net, 9-7. Sasicki puts it away. Make it 9-8.
That one was an easy point for her. Ball came right to her, two hands.
As a result of a really good serve by Souls.
Exactly.
Point Chemics. I'm going to call a lift on Dow on that one.
That was a rough.
We're tied up, Sarah.
Rough play for the Chargers.
9-9. That time put away by Tolt.
There, it is. There she is.
You were looking for her. And Tolt ends the Souls streak at the service line, but Souls, as she has done a lot this match, been able to string some points together when the Chemics needed it most. Hempling serving, Dow up by one. That's gonna be a kill for Rackaway. Tied up at 10.
Rackaway had a great placement, great dig by the Chargers, and they were unable to communicate on that second hit. I thought you were getting it, you thought I was getting it type of a play.
Yep. Well, McMath tries to find him sleeping. Alertly defended by Dow, but this time put away by Emma Wolf. Chemics take an 11-10 lead, and Dow is going to call timeout. So after Dow stormed a big early lead, Chemics have rallied back here to go up by one. Both coaches know this is just a huge game here. Midland up 2-1. Desperately wanting to end it at 4. Dow trying to stay alive.
Yeah, and the Chargers wanting to find where they were in that third set, replicate the energy and the consistency they had in the third set, and the Chemics trying to basically fight for their life to try to put this one away, as you said.
Sasicki serving. Oh, that was a great play. McCaffrey. Kill from the back line.
Ties it up at 11.
Just long. McCaffrey with the attempt. Midland up 12-11. Oh, what a job. McCaffrey at the net. Tied up at 12.
10-5.
It's a great response from the previous play. McCaffrey trying to shoot the ball down the line. Just missed and was able to get back, get the block for the play.
Oh, what a serve.
Jillian Skinner with the ace.
Midland kind of fell asleep right there. Oh, that's Jensen at the net. Denies the Chargers. 14-7. Sicky with the dig. Jensen up for the kill. Ball still alive. Oh, but hit into the net. Midland takes the 14-13 lead. Atten again at the net.
2-11.
Kaylee Arnold, number 2, senior defensive specialist, checks in for Midland with the score at 14. She receives. Math tries to catch him sleeping. Oh, big kill for the Chargers. Now up by one, 15-14.
Once again, going back and forth.
Be denied there. Dow goes up by two. And you need a big point. Just dial number 4 if you're Dow. And again at the net. Blocks Wolf. They go up by 3. Hatton making a series of big plays here. Dow increases their lead. It's going to be point Chargers again. So Midland came from behind, got back about even, and Dow stretching the lead again. Coach Zero seen enough. 18-14, Chargers on top. Again, folks, coverage of this volleyball match is being produced by MCT volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on Saturday, November 14th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to start your training. Learn about MCTV, how to become a TV producer, and get hands-on training to become a volunteer. Cost is just $45, which includes your first-year access membership fee. Call 837-3474, as you can see it on your screen there, or come down to MCTV Studio in the lower level of Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. Learn more at www.cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV or follow us on Facebook. Big crowd is into it now. They know. There's a ton on the line. It's Katie Underhill Dow's libero serves. Go to Atten. The dig by Arnold. Jensen puts it away. Big kill.
It was huge.
By Midland's kill leader. 18-15.
Huge coming out of the timeout, getting the kill, getting that momentum swung back to your side.
Time.
And then there's that.
And then there's that. Exactly. What do you do about that? That being Nadia Atten. Been a force all night long. Kosicki cross court. Looks like it took Atten a little bit by surprise. Point Chemex, 19-16. Oh, at the net, Haley Sosicki, Aaron Sheridan, point Chemex. Wow, that was impressive. Nadia Atten again from the back row with authority. Dow up by three. Sophia Lobo checks into the game, and she will serve for the Chargers. Rack away! The Amazing Grace puts it away. Midland down by two. Serve Kaylee Souls. And she delivers the ace. 20-19. Cuts the Charger lead in half. Big service error. Dow breathes a sigh of relief. And Hempling goes to the service line.
Increases their lead, 19-21.
By Quinn McCaffrey. 22-19.
Yeah, as much as we talk about this being senior night, it's nice to see a couple of underclassmen stepping up. Junior Nadia Atten, sophomore Quinn McCaffrey from the Chargers, and then sophomore Amazing Grace Reckaway from the Chemex. Looks like there's going to be a couple of good teams for a couple more years.
Yeah, absolutely, Sarah. Coach Zero going to talk this one over. Down by 3 points. Now. Again, quicken the timeout. On the court, ready to roll. Against strategizing a little bit longer.
Yeah, that gives them a little bit more time to motivate each other. You have the X's and O's that you talk about in the timeouts. But then you also get on the court, you get the feeling, you get a little more comfort being able to kind of get that momentum and get that energy started on your own with the time left on the court.
Templing to serve in the net. Might have got out of her rhythm just a little bit during that timeout. Chemix cut it to two. Sasicki on the line serving. Goes long. 22-21.
Number seven, Brianna Tult, looks a little frustrated. As we said, had a good early going. It's been a little cold as of late.
Big swing by McCaffrey. Just what Dow needed, 23-21. Tult to serve. Keeps it alive for Midland. Anton over the block. Set point. Chargers trying to knot this thing up at two. Tension mounts.
Both sections getting into this one.
Saves it. What a play. Wreckaway. Just long. Thought they got a piece of that one, but they should say no. And Dow takes the fourth set, 21-25. Wow. To recap, tonight, Midland takes the first set, 26-24. They take the second, 25-22. Both come from behind victories. Dow rolled in the third set, 25-18. And then that one back and forth held off a late Chemic rally to win 25-21. And we go into the fifth and deciding set. Valley League North title on the line. City championship on the line. Fifth and deciding set. First to 15. Got to win by two, of course. Once somebody reaches 8 points, you switch sides. Just in case there's some edge to one side or the other. So, wow. 2-2. Pressure on Midland, but they look fairly loose, so they're ready to roll. Idea. We sure did. What's on the line, but hey, keep it cool. Just play volleyball. Play your match. See what happens. I think Midland will. Middle serve first, which should be steer.
Yes, they are.
Will be. Dow trying to pull off. A tremendous comeback, down 2-0. Midland trying to stave it off. Going to Atten, and Atten puts it away right through the block.
That is definitely the way the Chargers want to start the fifth set.
Chemics!
And that's how the Chemics want to respond.
That's right, they respond 1-1. McMath to serve for Midland. She's a sophomore. Point Chemics. Sheridan with the kill for Midland. Go up 2-1. Quick set in the middle. Chemics unable to block it. Tied at 2. Underhill with a serve. Jensen finds the hole. Dow try to get their hand on it to keep it alive. Said it hit the wood. Chemics up 3-2. Wolf serving for Midland. Tense Midland student section. That's an ace. Dow thought it was going to stay along, but Wolf found the corner. Midland up 2.
And that's the most excitement I've seen from the Chemics side in a while now.
With a block. Try to catch Midland by surprise, but Jensen read it beautifully. Midland up 5-2. Dig by Steer. In the net, though. Big dig. Sheridan tried to get over the net, but was a little too tight. Point Chargers. Nadia Atten on the service line. And she's got the ace, 5-4. Something suspended up there. Came down quickly. Atten pounced on it. 5-5. Chemics a little disorganized there.
Yeah, it looked like a little miscommunication on the Chemics side that time.
And just like that, Dow takes the lead. Will come back of their own.
Seems like the Chargers give them an inch, they're taking a mile.
It's going to be a lift. Probably should have just hit that one over. Coach Zero is going to call timeout. Dow on top, 7-5. Dow has got some skip in their step right now. You can sense it. They fought back from down 2-0. It's a little deceiving because most of those were really close sets as it was. It could go either way. But here in the deciding fifth set, Midland took that 5-2 lead. Dow stormed back with five straight points.
As would be expected, not just at this point in the match, but throughout the entire match, there really hasn't been one team that came in and said, okay, this is your night. You have to lose this game for the other team to win. Both teams have really been in it the entire stretch.
Absolutely. Nadia Hatton drilled off five straight points from the service line, four straight. Now keeps it alive. Jensen, no, Dow alive again. Atten from the back row. Arnold gets it over. Oh, tried the quick set to Hempfling. Just not able to connect.
Was a really good volley, back and forth.
Yeah,
a couple
was.
Of good volleys.
You could just, it got quiet. The tension was mounting. Ellie Jensen serving. Recoy tried to pound that one away. Might have been ill-advised. It was a little too low probably to convert on that. 8-6 Dow. Recoy blocked. Dow seem more organized in their attack right now. Grace Recoy. Good read. Finds the gap. Cuts it to 8-7. Kaylee Souls serving. Point Chemex, tied at 8. Kaylee Souls. 9-8 Chemex. Dow High will call timeout.
It is her night from behind the service line.
Yeah, it is. Kaylee Souls has done a lot of damage tonight.
Man.
From the service line. Just when Midland desperately needed a little run, Souls comes in and delivers three straight. And Dow quickly out of the timeout.
All right, 9-8. Chemex leading the Chargers. Fifth set. Once again, can't get any better than this.
People got their money's worth tonight. Authority. Beautiful set. Recoy left no doubt. 10-8 Chemex.
Don't believe she's a sophomore. I don't believe it.
She had a huge night.
The power that girl has.
Once again, paints the line, 11-8, Midland. Dow will call timeout. We are in the fifth set, folks. 2-all here. City Championship, Saginaw Valley League North title on the line. It has been back and forth. Both teams duking it out, exchanging blows. Neither team giving an inch. Both teams desperately wanting this match. Kaylee Stoll is a senior, goes back to the service line.
Tensions are definitely rising in this Midland gym.
Breakaway again! Another big kill! Chemex.
Yeah, somebody today told me she was pretty good.
Oh, it sails wide. A brilliant run on the service line by Souls. Service error gives it back to Dow. 12-9. Hempling serving. Big by Atten. Well, Recaway tried to just squeeze it over the net, but a little short. 12-10 Dow. Back and forth we go. Just wide. Souls at the last minute pulls her hands back. Wisely, point Chemex, 13-10. Suzuki serving. And it goes long. Just too much adrenaline in that serve. Dow back to the service line.
More and more people. More and more people are standing up.
Wide. Oh, Recaway tried to find the line. So close. But Dow cuts the lead to one. 13-12. Three ball for Dow. They're going to set Atten. Steer with a great dig. Another great dig. Atten again. No! Denied! McMath at the net. What a play by the sophomore. Shocking everybody. 14-12 match point. Chemex. Steer with the serve. Big kill. Clutch play by McCaffrey. Back and forth we go. 14-13. Skinner with the serve. Jensen. Atten. Finds the hole. Tied up. Nadia Atten.
You had to expect that from this match.
Get any tighter than this. 14-all. Dow staving off a couple of match points. Atten puts away. Match point Dow. Midland will call timeout. It's a different game when Atten comes around on the rotation and gets to the front line.
Wow, that's all I have to say. Wow.
What a match. This is an instant classic. Both teams having comebacks. Back and forth we go.
Both teams undefeated.
high level of competition. Match point down. They'll be serving. Jillian Skinner.
Like both student sections are ready to rush the court and not sure which team is going to be doing it. At this point, 15-14, Chargers lead the Chemics. Fifth set. Like you said, classic in the making.
Here we go, folks. Oh, in the net! 15 all. Midland dodges a bullet. McMath to serve. Into Jensen. Great dig by Dow.
A couple people disagreed with that call, but that's an official's call.
Tough call when it's 15 all in the fifth set.
Chemics are asking for a little bit more of an understanding.
Zero wants an explanation, but really can't believe it. Nevertheless, match point Dow.
Again, this is senior night. This is the last home match for us.
Underhill to serve.
All the seniors tonight.
Atten. Chemics with the dig. Atten again. She got it. Puts it away. And Dow, furious comeback. Wins in five. Bedlam here in Midland Gym.
Nadia Atten.
Chargers come back from a 2-0 deficit. Epic fifth set. Both teams back and forth having match points. But Nadia Atten, the junior, has been a dominant force all night. Puts the match away. You are looking at your Saginaw Valley League North champion, Dow Chargers, victorious in a classic.
And the student section's waiting. Student section's waiting.
And the student section pours on the court for Dow to celebrate with their team.
Great
jubilation for the green and gold. Chemics, meanwhile, stunned, head home, heartbroken. See all the smiles on the court for the Dow High faithful. What a match here at Midland High. We're going to send it away for this important message, and we will be right back, folks. Spins, drives, touchdown, Chemics!
Good hard hit.
Want to get in the game? Join MCTV as an Access TV producer and produce programs like baseball, basketball, football, and more. Call MCTV at 837-3474 to get started. Get in the game and let's produce a program.
The Midland High Gymnasium, we just witnessed an instant classic is the Dow High Chargers prevailing 3-2, coming all the way back from an 0-2 deficit. Both teams fought their hearts out, left it all on the court. But in the end, the power of Natty Atten prevailed, getting the last couple of points there for Dow when they need it the most. And so, we mentioned Midland takes the first two, 26-24, 25-22, and then Dow storms back with the 25-18 in the third set, 25-21, and then winning 17-15 in the fifth and deciding set. Well, Sarah, it was all we could have hoped it to be.
It was that and more.
And so, again, we're going to wrap things up here on MCTV. Dave Marsh and Sarah Pavlachik bringing you all the action tonight. Hope you enjoyed this classic volleyball match, Midland versus Dow. We'll see you next time, everybody. Good night, all.